Hello thinkers, Jonas here. Have you ever tried to drive a car with no fuel, without a battery, with no wheels? Is that even possible? Well, we know it's not possible. Why? Because for it to work, we need all these components. Maybe it works in a similar way when you are trying to learn a language. Let's think about that. But first, if you like this channel and you want to give your support, your like really helps me out, and also your comments down there. Ask your questions. Do you have these persistent questions in your mind? Why can't I learn English? I have a problem with this, with that. Ask me and I'm gonna answer, all right? So this video here is about how to redefine your mind in order to learn English efficiently. I've selected 5 points that I consider to be extremely important. Of course, there are many other things, but I don't want to make this video extra long. So, let's go to number 1. There is no 100% comprehension. What? Yeah, when we listen to Portuguese, when we read texts in Portuguese in our first language, we don't understand 100% of what we read or of what we hear. This is the impression we have. We understand the message, and after one day we can remember a very, very small part of what another person said. The same thing happens when we learn other languages. It's not only for messages, it also is the same logics for specific words. People say, oh no, Jonas, I understand, I kinda understand this word in the context, but I want to understand it 100%. It doesn't exist. Why? Because different people use different words with different meanings in different contexts. That's just the truth. There's no way around that. When we learn how to accept that we are not going to understand everything 100%, it's not something terrifying. Oh my god, so I will never learn English 100%. No, it works to have you relax and feel good with the things that you do understand. So we need to concentrate on the positive things, on the parts of the text that we understand, and that's gonna give us context to understand extra things. Oh no, Jonas, but if I read or if I watch a movie and I don't understand that part, I just ask you one question. Is your head gonna fall off? No. So that's it. With practice, you start understanding more and more. Number 2. Always think, how is this activity, how is this practice gonna really help my brain comprehend and automatize English? Many people hear suggestions from teachers, from infinite teachers on YouTube, in their schools, do this, do that, do that. You can't listen to me and believe everything I say. No, I might be wrong. I'm a human being. I say wrong things. You need to listen and think, okay, does this make sense? If I exercise pronunciation only by listening and pronouncing separate words, is this going to help me to speak English fast? No, because I need to connect words, so this exercise is not that good. I need another exercise in order to give me a wholesome, like a complete exercise, a complete practice, a complete training. Always think, how is this going to help my specific brain? Because sometimes an exercise is very good for someone, but for someone else, it can be disastrous. Maybe I'm exaggerating a little bit, but yes, sometimes, for example, using translation. People that already think a little bit in English, when they start using translation, it's not gonna destroy what they are learning. But when people are starting and people already have this connection to Portuguese, they can't let it go. It can make them take many steps back. Number 3. Am I improving my abilities, my skills, or am I lying to myself? I take this question and I give you another example. The example of watching a movie with subtitles in Portuguese. Oh no, teacher, but when I watch a movie with subtitles in English, I understand only 10%. So I'm not learning. When I watch them with subtitles in Portuguese, I understand 80%. Wait, are you really thinking that when you watch a movie with subtitles in Portuguese, your English is improving? No, you are understanding because of the Portuguese language. Words in Portuguese have this meaning. Maybe the word in English has this meaning, not exactly this here, but this. It works in part of this situation, like we use in Portuguese, but it doesn't work for other million situations. So when you learn by comparing English with Portuguese and you are not prepared for that, that's why I only use translation for students in the advanced level, you close your point of view and then you don't understand that words have generic meanings that can be adapted to different situations. And then you memorize that still is ainda. And then you see that ainda in Portuguese can be many words in English in different situations, and that still, when you translate into Portuguese, can be infinite words depending on the situation. They don't totally agree with each other. Even in Portuguese, bonito is not equal to lindo. Words have areas of meaning. They don't have a specific meaning. Most of them, at least. Number four, filter these absolute tips that teachers give you. For example, don't say you're welcome when someone says thank you. Maybe that person's family don't use that. Maybe people in the person's city doesn't use that. But I have heard tons of Americans using this expression in a daily basis. My friends use that. You hear people using that in movies, in TV shows, everywhere. Sometimes Brazilians do that. When Brazilians are teaching Portuguese to foreigners, they say, no, don't use this expression, this is wrong. And they are wrong, because that expression does exist, and many people in other parts of Brazil use that. It's like when people say, the correct pronunciation is a gente. Have you ever notice that there are so many, especially Americans, that speak Portuguese like a gente está falando a verdade, and they exaggerate this tch, this tch. It seems that saliva is gonna come out. Why? Because they are learning a specific accent, a specific way of speaking. That doesn't mean that other forms of pronunciation, other expressions are wrong. But maybe some Brazilian people are saying that that is the right way to speak. Sometimes it's not. Sometimes there are variations. Number five, last one. Practice the thing that you need, speaking, listening, writing, reading, without forgetting to connect everything. When you practice speaking, you are practicing listening too. When you practice listening, you need to imitate that sound, because imitating helps you understand how people speak. Don't disconnect things. That's terrible. That's what schools do. And you know that people go to school in Brazil and they don't learn English. Why? Because today we are going to learn present simple. But if you understand the positions of words, the structure of English, it's the same structure for present simple, present perfect. It's the same structure for present continuous. And the same thing for the past of all these forms. No, Jonas, it's different because one has ing. That's conjugation. that's a specific difference in the word. It's not a difference in the sequence of words, in the positions of the words. And that verb is always going to accept that specific form or those specific forms. You need to start comprehending everything. This is what was super hard for me when I was studying in school. And when I started studying by myself, I found out, my God, everything is connected. And if I study things connecting all the points, I'm starting to understand what these things really mean. And then I could understand English by myself and learn the language in front of my computer, in front of my TV, not in a school. And then after that, start using the same techniques to teach you and to teach all my students in my online lessons. You can also be my student in my online lessons, but for example, if you don't have money, if you really don't have time, you can do these other practices for free at home. Well, if you don't have time, it's not a good idea to practice by yourself, because it's gonna take a super long time for you to reach the point. Normally, when you have a tutor guiding you through a logical way, you can accelerate the improvement of your fluency in a language, all right? So, that's it. I hope you have liked these 5 points. Are there other points you think are also important? Leave them in the comments and see you on the next video. Bye.